I ask you this question, what's the most expensive resource in a wireless communication network? So let me repeat the question. What's the most expensive commodity or resource an operator will pay for in wireless communication network? Now, some of you know already, it is the spectrum. Operators will pay billions of dollars to lease a spectrum, not to purchase it, but to lease it for, let's say, another 5 or 10 years. So it intuitively makes sense to monitor that specific spectrum, how it is being used. And that's what we are going to discuss here. What strategies eNodeB and UE can run in order to monitor the usage of radio resources in the wireless link. Let's take an example. First of all, why do we need to monitor or supervise the connection, the wireless connection, and then we will go and take a look what are the schemes running on the downlink and uplink side in order to monitor it. So let's take a scenario here. Assuming we have two users, let's say this is a site, one user who is standing here, and then we have another user who is standing over here. Let's say one user is Jack and then the other user here is Ryan. Now let's say both Jack and Ryan have the same data plan. They have the same services. They pay the same amount of subscription every month to get the services. You can see evidently that Ryan is standing in poor RF coverage compared to Jack. And let's say both are running the same services on their phone at that specific instant. So the question comes up is how and what time, in other words, how the quality of experience for both the users will be. Now you can say apparently, well, Ryan in this case will not have a good quality of experience since he is standing at the edge of the cell. His experience will be a little bit worse compared to the experience what Jack will have at this moment. This is correct. However, the next question which comes up is Ryan being charged less at this point while he's having a poor quality of experience, or is Jack being charged a little bit more for having the good experience? The answer is Ryan is still being charged the same and Jack is still being charged the same. And even for that bad coverage or poor service, Ryan will still be paying to have a connection. So in this case, if I may say that Ryan is being charged unduly because he's not getting the same kind of quality of service, quality of experience for which he is paying, whereas Jack standing in good coverage is getting a better experience. So with that being said, that's point number one. Another point which we need to consider here is since Ryan is standing in bad coverage, then eNodeB will have to make more number of attempts to deliver the same amount of data to Ryan. In other words, if it just takes one attempt to deliver an amount of data to Jack, it will take maybe two or three times to deliver the same amount of data. And the modulation scheme in that specific scenario will be much lesser. The modulation scheme will be QPSK compared to Jack's scenario where it will be 16 QAM or 64 QAM. So in that case, the other point is efficient usage of resources. In this case, we are not using the resources efficiently, specifically in this particular case. So in terms of points, let me write it up. Point number one is that undue charge to the customers. We want to avoid undue charging to the customers with monitoring of wireless resources or usage of wireless resources, undue charging to the customer. That needs to be avoided. Another point is we need to make sure that there is efficient usage of resources. Now, in case where Ryan is standing, the resources are not being used efficiently in this case. Why? Because eNodeB will be using more number of resources. Though eNodeB will be using lower modulation scheme, but then the more number of attempts will be consuming more bandwidth and it will require more resources on the part of eNodeB compared to sending the same amount of information to Jack. So the idea here is that rather than sending Ryan all these retransmissions, Ryan will not be happy at the end of the day and eNodeB will be investing more resources in this case. So what should be done instead? There should be an efficient resource usage strategy where users at the edge of the cell should either be getting the same amount of service or either they should be given a resources or connection where they can have good coverage resources. The third point to consider is if Ryan keeps standing in this particular coverage where he is and he does not move, then in that case, resources will remain hanging for that user. When I say resources will remain hanging, meaning the quality of experience will neither improve. In other words, this will result in hanging of the resources from the perspective of eNode B. So that kind of user will be a burden on the network. Plus, on top of that, this kind of user will not be happy. It will not be getting good quality of experience. So these three points are evident or explain automatically why do we need to have efficient resource utilization, why do we need to have wireless connection supervision or radio connection supervision. So these are the main goals of radio connection supervision, and as I mentioned earlier, it is the most expensive commodity or resources. Now next point comes is, what does eNode B take into account when it comes to radio connection supervision? So from the perspective of eNode B, there are two things eNode B does on the downlink side. One of them is radio link control, the other one is inactivity supervision. So I'll explain these two in the downlink, and then we'll talk about how UE monitors these resources in the uplink. So first of all, let's talk about inactivity supervision. The way inactivity supervision works is, if this is your site and you have a UE over here, so in this case, let's say there are a number of users which are connected. In fact, not one UE, but a number of users. And all of them are RRC connected. So let's say this one is RRC connected, this one is RRC connected, the other user is RRC connected, so is the third user. And let's number them. This user is number 1, 2, 3, all the way up to 100. So let's say there are 100 users connected. Now here is the thing, even if a user is connected, it does not mean that user is being scheduled after every 1 millisecond. The TTI in LTE is 1 millisecond. So the important thing to remember is, if a user is RRC connected, does not mean that after every 1 millisecond that will be receiving data in downlink or it will be sending data in the uplink. That user may be just RRC connected and occupying the resources for RRC connected user, but not using those resources. Now, what can eNode B do from the perspective of radio connection supervision? Rather than letting that user keep preserving those resources for that user, it is better to allow such a user to go into idle mode based on inactivity. So in inactivity supervision, what happens is, whenever a user is RRC connected, if it does not do anything, then eNode B starts running a timer, which is termed as inactivity timer. Different operators can have the different values for these timers, and they can have different names for this timer. I will label it over here as inactivity timer. So based on this inactivity timer duration, let's say if its value is, for example, let's say 10 seconds. So if a particular user is connected, let me erase this and write the correct value here. So let's say, for example, its value is 10 seconds. So if a user is RRC connected and 10 seconds have passed by and that RRC connected user is not doing anything, then at the expiry of these 10 seconds, eNode B will make an executive decision and move those users into idle mode. So this is called as normal released. In other words, let's say first three users are not doing anything and inactivity timer expires, they will be moved into RRC idle mode. Now, why would eNode B will take such an action? Because the idea here is, it is better to release those users into idle mode and save the resources rather than letting those users remain RRC connected. Because in that case, those users will be holding up the resources for RRC connection for other users who wants to get connected and keep using the resources. So that's one way we have in which case we use RRC radio connection supervision or wireless connection supervision in case of LTE. The other scenario is the way eNode B monitors inactivity. The other way eNode B monitors radio connection supervision is based on radio link control. And what is that radio link control? Let's discuss that over here. And in this case, I will have to draw the protocol stack over here for eNode B, and this is the protocol stack for the eNode B. If I draw it from the perspective of user plane, we will have PDCP, then we will have RLC, then we will have MAC layer, and then we will have physical layer at the bottom. So PDCP, RLC, MAC, and physical layer. Now, what happens at RLC layer? We have automatic repeat request, ARQ, running. At MAC layer, we have hybrid ARQ, which is running. So what happens is, if this is a user which is connected, and this user, let's say, is standing at the edge of the cell. Hybrid ARQ, let's say if it has a value of 4, and ARQ also has a value of 4, let's say, for example, 4. The objective of these Hybrid ARQ and ERQ is that in case user is unable to receive information or data, then the information will be retransmitted for the users until the user receive it. And it will happen based on soft combining or based on different redundancy versions, so on and so forth. Now, let's say the user is standing at the edge of the cell and call this user as Adam. So Adam is standing at the edge of the cell. And in this case, when the transmission is sent, as a result of this transmission, if based on poor RF coverage, user could not decode it, what will happen? E0B will retransmit the same version once again. So same redundancy version or different redundancy version, and then it will make another attempt. Let's say if the user is standing in a worst RF coverage, that even though number of retransmission attempts do expire and user is unable to receive data information, then what will happen is E0B will conclude in that specific scenario that it is a radio link control failure or RLC failure. How does this happen is if we have four retransmission attempts at hybrid ARQ level and then four retransmission attempts at ARQ level, first a hybrid ARQ will try four attempts. If it does not, if the packet is not received, then it will go to the upper layer and it will tell RLC that give me the new packet once again. RLC will transmit the packet, and then again hybrid ARQ will try four more attempts. The end user is unable to receive it. Again, the same procedure will run. All in all, in total, the system will attempt, let's just say in this example, it will attempt 16 retransmission attempts. Just for this case, assuming ARQ and hybrid ARQ. If the end user does not receive the packet at the expiry of this retransmission limit, E0B will decide, okay, in this case, the user has a radio link control failure, though E0B wants user to be connected, but in this case, user is not having a good quality of experience. It is consuming the resources. Maximum retransmission limits have already expired. So it's better to release such a user into idle mode as a result of radio link control failure, also termed as bearer failure. In this case, user will be moved into idle mode. It can come back. The user can come back and get connected once it comes back in good coverage. However, this particular scenario is another way of doing radio connection supervision. Different operators and vendors will have different values for this particular parameter, which controls how many retransmission attempts are allowed. And based on that retransmission attempts, when that expires, then UE is moved into idle mode. This is termed as radio link control failure. So these are the two ways in case of downlink, E0B can monitor the specific connection supervision of the UE.